A warning from credit rating agency S&P Global Ratings. A fast-spreading coronavirus outbreak could knock over $200 billion off the combined economies in the Asia-Pacific region. Among the most exposed, Australia, Hong Kong, Japan, Korea, Singapore, and Thailand, all seen to enter or come close to a recession due to risks from local transmission of the virus to tighter financial conditions. S&P, meanwhile, cut its growth forecast for China, the epicenter of the outbreak, to 4.8%. As the health crisis deepens, the global economy is at risk. Economic think tank, the Economist Intelligence Unit, has revised its global growth forecast downward due to the health crisis. It sees global economy growing just 1.9% this year from its earlier forecast range of 2.3% to 2.9%.
I think the level of risk will be determined by the openness of the country to international trade. Any country that relies on its external sector, or, for example, flows of international tourists, which is the case for many Southeast Asian countries, then they are exposed to the risk.
The Asian Development Bank says the economic impact of the outbreak could come between $77 billion to $347 billion, or up to 0.4% of global GDP, depending on how long the health crisis would last. It adds the losses will be spread across different channels, including tourism, trade, and domestic demand. The ADB adding, the health emergency will have a significant impact on developing Asian economies. As for the Philippines, ADB says Manila's economic growth will take a hit if the cases will rise further.
Epidemic, COVID-19 epidemic happened in the Philippines as well. Then Philippines gonna encounter GDP losses as high as 0.7% point.
Even the U.S. economy may not be spared. But U.S. President Donald Trump assures Americans his administration is capable of handling the outbreak.
So, it's going to all work out. Everybody has to be calm.
The bulk of COVID-19 cases are still in China, but there has been a significant development in China's central province of Hubei, as it reported zero new cases over 24 hours for the first time during the outbreak, excluding Wuhan. Global infections are already nearing the 100,000 mark, while fatalities are now over 3,300. Ron Cruz, ABS-CBN News.